Hello students, today we shall cover the explanation of the lesson, the last lesson by Alfonso Daudet, part 3. So in our previous class, we had studied when Berlin ordered that the French language would no longer be taught in schools in the French districts of Alsace and Lorraine, it stayed or moved the otherwise lazy Frenchmen. Suddenly, they all had a strong desire to learn how to read and write their mother tongue, which was French. It was not only the children who went to the school, but also the elders of the village who had not studied seriously French in their childhood and kept putting off unimportant works to the next day. The day finally arrived as the last day of the French language in the schools. And they became serious and keen to learn as they feel the German would laugh at them for not knowing their own language. They are also ashamed of themselves when the teacher says that this lack of knowledge is the reason for their defeat to the Germans and asks them to protect their mother tongue as being close to one's language is the key to escape from the prison of slavery. So children, we also learned that France also had a sudden change in his attitude towards studies and for wasting his time in hunting birds' eggs and playing in the Saar River, which was flowing in France. Until now, France had considered his books to be unwanted burden, but suddenly he starts considering them to be his best friends, whom he would never leave. So the writer wants to show the change in France attitudes towards studying after hearing the news. So the author also says that author means France is the narrator of the story, so I can call it as France is the narrator of the story. So France says that the news that their teacher M. Hamel was leaving had a similar impact on him. France didn't want him to go away and he no longer thought the teacher to be very short-tempered and strict. For him now, M. Hamel was not a short-tempered teacher, neither a short-tempered nor strict one. Because now he had realized that the village man had come to pay respect and thank M. Hamel for his service of 40 years in the school. So now let's see today's explanation. While I was thinking of all this, I heard my name called. It was my turn to recite. What would I not have given to be able to say that dreadful rule for the participle all through very loud and clear and without one mistake. But I got mixed up on the first words and stood there holding on to my desk, my heart beating and not daring to look up. So children, here the narrator, Franz is talking about his thought that while he was thinking about all these things, he heard his teacher calling out his name to recite the topic of participles. So as the news had impacted France, he was eager to study and he has realized the importance of his native language. So he was desperate to show his eagerness towards his language and he was called to speak on the participle rules. Though he tried hard to be very loud and clear in his explanation of the rule for the participle without any mistake, but what happened? He got very nervous and he got confused on the very first words and he couldn't speak, rather his heart started beating and he couldn't dare or he had no courage to face his teacher because he was ashamed of himself that he got confused and he was standing quietly in front of his teacher for he didn't know the lesson or the rules of participle which his teacher had asked him to recite in the class. I heard M. Hamel say to me, "I won't scold you. Little Franz, you must feel bad enough. See how is it?" So Mr. Hamel or M. Hamel said to Franz that he would not scold him as now. Earlier, M. Hamel was a very strict and short-tempered teacher and at a very slight or a petty mistake, he would scold Franz. But today he was very silent, he was very calm and he said to Franz that even if you couldn't speak or he got confused at the first word, he would not scold him as now he had realized his mistake. And every day Franz told himself that he would study the next day and now the opportunity to study had ended and he knew nothing. So now it was too late. The teacher made Franz realize that it was too late for the people of the France and even for the for France to learn this language, because only it was a single day in the hand of M. Hamel to teach this language. Because till now those people and especially the students including France, they were putting off this language, they were not paying attention towards this their native language. So now he make him realize and says that now you see where we have come out. That means that they have wasted their time till now and they couldn't learn it well, and that is why he got confused at the very first word. Ah, that's the great trouble with Alice. Now M. Hamel is sarcastic in his tone and he says that this is what is a big problem with all Alices. And she here is Alices. She here represents the people of Alices who were putting off or who were delaying learning till tomorrow. And tomorrow never came and the last day of the France teacher arrived. So the people were very nervous today. Even France was nervous and all were trying to speak, but they can never neither speak nor write their own language. So this is what M. Hamel tried to explain or tried to instill in the mind of those people, and also call them that they were not the worst poor little France, and they had all a great deal to reproach themselves with. That means he mean to say that that they only show to be Frenchmen as they cannot they can neither speak nor write their own language. That means they only pretend to be Frenchmen. If they were real Frenchmen, they would have really known their language. They would have surely spoken and would have written skill in their own language. They would have command in their language, but they were only for a formality called to be Frenchmen, but they had no knowledge of neither speaking nor writing their own language. So M. Hamel says that France should not feel guilty as everyone is at fault. So it is not only the mistake of France that he couldn't learn or he didn't learn his own language, but it is the fault of everyone. Now M. Hamel speaks about the parents. What he says: your parents were not anxious enough to have you learn. Now M. Hamel blames the parents also, and he says that Franz's parents were not interested in getting him educated as they wanted him to work at a farm or a mill and earn some money. And he even blamed himself. And why he blames himself? So he says that as a teacher he was also not interested in teaching them, and he would send them to his home to water the plants, and sometimes he would declare a holiday and go for fishing. So the teacher is blaming the parents and himself too for not making those students, for not making those people understand the value of their language, and they could now at this position they were neither able to speak nor able to write. So the teacher is also reproaching himself, is blaming himself, apart from the parents, apart from the villagers, those who were present over there. Now then, from one thing to another, M. Hamel went on to talk of the French language, saying that it was the most beautiful language in the world, the clearest, the most logical, that we must guard it amongst us and never forget it. Because when a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. Now M. Hamel start praising their mother tongue, French language, as being the most beautiful, clearest and the most logical language in the world. Just like in India, Sanskrit is the most clearest and the most logical language in the world. In the same way, the teacher M. Hamel is speaking or praising their mother tongue, French language, and he calls this language being the most beautiful one, the clearest one, and the most logical one. And at the same time, he appealed to everyone in the class to protect their language. Why he asked them to do so, to protect the language or to guard their language? Because according to him, it is the only way to free ourselves from the prison of slavery. Because he wanted to tell those people that if they are not going to learn their own language, if they won't have command over their own language, then it is for sure that the other countries would rule over them and they would make them their slave. Just like very recently in the 1870-71 war, Prussia had defeated France and those two districts, Alsace and Lorraine, had been captured by Prussia. And the rule of German language to be taught in the classroom, in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine had been imposed. So this is what is the real fact. Anne Hamel tried to make those people understand that if a person knows his mother tongue well, then no one can enslave them. Knowing the mother tongue well as a language is a tool to fight domination. So Anne Hamel tried to enlighten the people of France and the children of France that if they want to live a free life, so they must have the knowledge of their mother tongue well. So knowing the mother tongue well as a language is a tool. Tool for what? Tool to fight against slavery. So children, I hope that this much of portion is well understood by you. Now children, it's time for your homework. Today we shall discuss a question and listen carefully so that you may able to answer this one. I will also give you the answer along with this question. So write this answer in your notebook. So let's see the question. The people in this story suddenly realize how precious their language is to them. What shows you this and why does this happen? So the answer is, when the village men realize that their mother tongue, French, will no longer be taught to them and it would be replaced by German, the very next day they realize its importance. Suddenly they develop an inclination towards learning this language and they attend the last lesson of French. Bring their old tone premiers to learn the language, which shows their eagerness. They also regret putting off learning French to the next day, and now finally the last lesson has arrived and they cannot read and even write their own language. Now they are ashamed of themselves and realize that the Germans have overpowered them due to their lack of knowing their own knowledge, and those people would be enslaved very soon because they had not learned their own language. And M. Hamel made them realize this fact that knowing one's own native language is the key to their prison. That means if they have not learned their own language, then what will happen to them? Then they will be enslaved by the other powerful countries. And that's what happened with those two districts of France, Alsace and Lorraine. Those two districts were captured by Prussian in the war of 1870-71. So children, I hope this question is followed by you. So do this question as a homework for your day. Thank you to all of you. See you in our next class.